Hello everyone, myself Diksha Pandey, PhD scholar at University of Delhi. First of all, I would like to thank entire Incorp team for selecting me and giving me opportunity to share my work with all of you, which is entitled on Back Efflux Spread, a two-tier system to predict and categorize bacterial efflux-mediated antibiotic resistance protein. Before getting into my work, I would like to give you background on antibiotic resistance. So the left-hand side figure shows the mortality rate, 10,000 per population as per WHO report. Out of all, Asia has reported most number of deaths as compared to others. Now to give you a background, how does AR occur? So the lot of germs are few are drug resistant. Now in antibiotic kill bacteria causing the illness as well as good bacteria protecting the body from infection. The drug resistant bacteria not allowed to grow and take over. And in last, some bacteria give their drug resistant to other mechanism causing more problems. In this entire process, various mechanisms are involved, like enzyme inactivation, alteration of target site, decreased permeability of cell, and last but not least, efflux pump, which is very important, and here I'm mainly focused on this mechanism. Efflux simply means flowing out of a substance, particles like antibiotic off out of a cell. This mechanism is important in medicine as it can contribute to bacterial antibiotic resistance. Efflux involves a lot of pumps, which are proteinaceous transporters, are mainly divided into five classes, and they require energy to perform their function. And further, they are classified as primary and secondary active transporters. Taking into this consideration, my goal was to develop a tool which can predict bacterial efflux protein, because when I was going to the literatures, I was unable to find any such tool which can predict or classify bacterial efflux conferring antibiotic resistance protein. So I developed a two-tier prediction tool named as Back Efflux Spread, which is highly effective and quick with 85% accuracy at both tiers. This is freely accessible at the mentioned link on the screen. This work has been also published in scientific report if anyone wants to read further. Please go through the paper. This slide talks about the data curation, compilation and distribution. Here I have used three type of protein information which is mentioned here. And the data is taken from UniProt and are inbuilt resources like backyard scan. This is the overall statistic of the data. Initially, we found this much of data. After that, we have removed the redundancy among the sequences. We used CD8 40% and then we annotated the sequences. And then we finally came up with total 1342 sequences. And then further, we divided into 5x6 as a training purpose, and 1x6 is used for a testing purpose. Similarly, in tier 2 data set, but in tier 2 data set, we have used only bacterial proteins of efflux pump which conferring antibiotic resistance. So, similarly, in tier 1, we have used a UniProt, but here I have used Patrick database. So, I found this much of sequences. Then we removed the CD8, then we removed the redundancy using CD8 40%. Then we annotated, and further, we found a total 210 protein. Similarly, in tier 1, we have further divided into 5x6 is used for training and 1x6 used for testing. In any machine learning method, required a fixed length input. So, hence to transform a variable length 20 cross n matrix into a fixed dimension 20 cross 20 matrix. So, here I have used a complete protein sequences. So the complete protein sequences length varies, protein length varies. Then we did a column-wise addition of PSSM score of each 20 type of amino acid. Here we have used a CyBlast against NR database. NR database is a non-redundant database. After removing redundancy at 90% using CD-HIT. We have used a three iteration of CyBlast search with E value 0.001. Then a machine learning method, we have used SVM, is a most popular kernel based machine learning method. And during optimization SVM model, we have used several parameters and kernel features like linear, polynomial, radial and sigmoid. And then we evaluate the performance of a prediction model on data set that is not used to train the model. So here I have used a Lieberknecht cross validation method because Lieberknecht cross validation is less biased. So what actually Lieberknecht cross validation does, if there are n data point, the original samples, then n minus p samples are used to train the model and p points are used as a validation set. In both tiers, we have used a Lieberknecht cross validation. Then we have evaluated the performance. So we have used these parameters, sensitivity, specificity, accuracy, MCC. The MCC is basically a very important measure of prediction capability that reflects the balance between specificity and sensitivity. The range of MCC values lies between -1 to +1. This is the overall schema to classify a prediction into different categories. So this is an example of predicted versus actual. So in both tiers, tier 1 and tier 2. This is benchmarking result of training and testing. In the first column, it is selected threshold where I found the maximum accuracy of designed models. In tier 1, we found 85% accuracy in training data set, while in independent data set, we found 94% accuracy. While in tier 2 data set, we found a high accuracy in all cases, like above 90% accuracy, while in independent designers, we found a above 93% accuracy. But while in some cases also, we found a 100% accuracy in some cases. It concludes that our design model have a significant prediction capability. This is the ROC plot. As you can see here, all the models lies near the one, which conclude that both SVM models have very high prediction efficiency of both tiers. Then we have implemented a web server and a standalone tool. This is the overall schema of proposed tool. If user has submitted the sequences, so in tier 1, it will decide like whether it is bacterial AR efflux protein, efflux or non. If it is non, it will stop immediately. If it is AR, then it will go further and it will classify it into various subfamilies in tier 2. This is the web resources of design tool. This is the home page. This is a download page. Here user can download the data set or a standalone tool. Standalone tool is basically built for the bulk analysis. This is the submission page. Here user can submit or browse their sequence file, and user can play with the SVM threshold. Although we have fixed the default threshold -0.4. And it will give the prediction result like this. So in the first column, it will show the protein ID and the prediction result. It is freely accessible using this link. Now I would like to summarize my work. We have designed a prediction engine to predict the bacterial efflux conferring AR protein, and it's classified into different subfamilies using efflux and non-efflux proteins and their subfamilies information. We have also built a web server back efflux spread, and it's standalone version for bulk data analysis and general use. We anticipate that back efflux would help the scientific community in their new insight into the efflux mechanism of AR. Though on the basis of current compilation and knowledge, we intend to keep it updated with the newly emerging bacterial efflux conferring AR proteins. To give my future perspective, we'll be using current knowledge and compilation. We look forward to analyze other factors and other mechanisms associated with antibiotic resistance. This is the screenshot of my paper. Now I would like to acknowledge University of Delhi, South Campus, my funding agency, Department of Science and Technology, my PhD supervisor, Dr. Manish Kumar, and all members of our department for their contribution and support. Thank you for listening. If anyone has questions, I am happy to answer.